morning, everyone. I do pray and trust that you are safe and you are well, and that you are able to give God the glory this morning. My name is Reverend Neville Popo, and you know, this morning I want to be able to share with you something wonderful, that you would receive it in your heart and that you would walk with it and trust God in all your endeavors today. God is so good to us. He's working all the time, keeping us and protecting us from all manner of things, things that we see and things that we don't see. But we give glory to him for who he is. And so this morning, I just want to just give a little tribute to a dear friend who has passed and gone home to glory. He is Pastor Lenford Quashie. And he is a minister of God and also a musician. Our brother was a man that was dedicated to God. He was a man that was vibrant and full of passion. He was a man that encouraged you all the time when you saw him. He was beautiful in the sense that his heart was always warm and generous to anyone that he came into contact with. And so my memories of him are those of good thoughts and good intentions, a person that would go out of his way the extra mile just to support his brother, his sister, and those that were in need. And so this morning, as we come together to worship, let us take the time to give thanks for our brothers and our sisters that are gone from us. And let us take time to remember that God is still on the throne doing great things. Have a great day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Because I know he
So I want to share with you a few verses of scripture from the book of Daniel, chapter 4, and you know, help to give you encouragement in relation to your life, and to know that God has favor in you. We sometimes don't recognize the favor that God has in us, and I want us to understand how much God cares and does actually love us, even though sometimes it seems as though he doesn't. And so I want us to look at the book of Daniel, chapter 4, verse 4, and it says, I, Nebuchadnezzar, was at home in my palace, contented and prosperous. Verse 5, I had a dream that made me afraid as I was lying in bed. The images and visions that passed through my mind terrified me. So I commanded that all the wise men of Babylon be brought before me to interpret the dream for me. When the magicians, enchanters, astrologers, and diviners came, I told them the dream, but they could not interpret it for me. And verse 8 says, finally, Daniel came into my presence, and I told him the dream. He is called Belshazzar, after the name of my God, and the spirit of the holy gods is in him. So you see, he called upon Daniel. Now, this is the second time that he's called upon Daniel to come and interpret his dream. And it is the second time that the others that he had called upon, the magicians and astrologers, enchanters, diviners, and so on, all of these had failed him. It's the second time. The first time round, he threatened to kill all of them. And this is the second time round, and then they failed him again. But here he's calling Daniel for the second time. And again, for the second time, Daniel is interpreting the dream. And I look at this dream, and I call it, or give it a theme of, you know, God's favor. And the reason why I give it God's favor is because of the way God has moved amongst the children of Israel throughout their captivity. Now, they ended up in captivity because of their disobedience to God. But as a father, though he allowed King Nebuchadnezzar to besiege them and to put them into captivity, this is a punishment that he gave to them. It's the father chastising his children, if you like. But it didn't mean that he didn't care or love them. And even though he had done this, it was to teach them a lesson. Now, amongst them were some very strong men of faith, Daniel being one of them. And there were other men such as Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who also were in captivity with Daniel. Now, what I want us to be focusing on and to recognize is how King Nebuchadnezzar had to look to Daniel for this interpretation, but also to understand that God had come into Nebuchadnezzar's life and had increased his borders and blessed him, even though he did not have any kind of an allegiance to God. He blessed him just the same. And this is a part of his plan and strategy to bring the children of Israel back to him, and to also have the king Nebuchadnezzar to also bow before him and recognize that he is God. So here we are in this situation, and this is what's happening. So Daniel now in verse 19 begins to share the dream to the king. And going down into verse 23, he says, Your Majesty, saw a holy one, a messenger, coming down from heaven and saying, cut down the tree and destroy it, but leave the stump bound with iron and bronze in the grass of the field while its roots remain in the ground. Let him be drenched with the dew of heaven. Let him live with the wild animals until seven times pass by for him. And so, you know, the king, you know, heard this and, you know, was a little bit troubled by it. But still, Daniel had to go on to tell him further the dream. And so Daniel says, this is the interpretation, Your Majesty. And this is the decree the Most High has issued against my lord the king. You will be driven away from people and will live with wild animals. You will eat grass like the ox and be drenched with the dew of heaven. Seven times will pass by for you until you acknowledge that the Most High is sovereign over all kingdoms on earth and gives them to anyone he wishes. The command to leave the stump of the tree with its roots means that your kingdom will be restored to you when you acknowledge that heaven rules. Therefore, Your Majesty, be pleased to accept my advice. Renounce your sins by doing what is right and your wickedness by being kind to the oppressed. It may be that then your prosperity will continue. And so this is what was being said to the king and advised to the king to do. God has showed favor right through to Daniel, because the king could have had him killed, but God had had favor over him that he would listen to the instruction. Now, even though he had heard what Daniel had said, it took him 12 months before he understood what God was saying, because he had done nothing about it. Have you ever been in that position where God has spoken to you and you've not taken no action? You've not responded? You've not done nothing? The good thing is that even though that may happen to you, God's grace is sufficient to keep you. That he gives you favor and allows you time to still come back to him and put right whatever you've done that is wrong. And so his favor is upon your life still to correct the wrongs. And so it was with Nebuchadnezzar. And so the dream came to pass that he was driven out of the kingdom and he had to live with the animals and feed like the ox, eating grass all day long. And so he realized after a while that, wow, the dream has come to pass. And so, you know, to shorten the story, we find that the king turned around his life and acknowledged the God of Israel, the God of Jacob, the God of Abraham. He acknowledged who he was and apologized to God Almighty, Abba Father. He apologized and he also gave honor and glory to the king. He acknowledged God, he acknowledged his sins, and he apologized. And God heard him and God blessed him. And you see that God was true to his word. He restored all of his land. He restored all of his wealth. And he gave him even more on top because he had acknowledged who he was. I want you to understand that as a child of the king, as a follower of Christ, that when you acknowledge him for who you are, when you bring your sins before God, and this is also for those that don't know Christ, when you bring your sins before God, when you acknowledge that he is the Almighty God, then changes will come in your life where God will restore you and will rebuild you and will give you all that you need. And you know, hard times will come, but whilst you continue to trust him and allow your faith to be like Daniel, then God will bless you. So I want you to just be aware of that today and to embrace God and embrace what he offers to you today. Just give up your life to him. Confess your sins to him and let him lead you into the path of righteousness. Let him fulfill your life as it ought to be fulfilled. In the name of Jesus, amen.
I hear the Savior say, my strength is small, child of weakness, watch and pray, find in thee thine all in all. Jesus made it all, cause to be my own. Sin had left a prison stain.
Change my